To practice zigzag stitches, we select a medium-sized zigzag on the setting dial. Then we select the medium settings on the length dial. Place the fabric beneath the foot presser. This time we align the edge of the foot presser with the previous straight stitch line. Bring down the foot presser. Hold the hanging threads behind the foot presser and sew two stitches by turning the hand wheel. Hold the fabric with both hands and start sewing at a low speed. Keep an eye on the alignment. When we finish the line, we bring the needle to its highest position. Lift the foot presser. Remove the fabric and cut the threads. Now we are going to sew different zigzag stitches. Place the fabric under the foot presser. This time we align the previous stitch line with the right edge of the foot presser. Bring down the foot presser and hold the hanging threads and sew two stitches by turning the hand wheel. While we are sewing this line, we try different stitch widths and lengths to vary the size of the zigzags to compare the results. We keep an eye on the alignment. When turning the dials, we make sure that the needle is not in the fabric. By selecting a larger size zigzag pattern on the selector dial, the zigzag will be wider. By setting the stitch length dial on a smaller number, the zigzag stitches will be closer to each other. Turning the stitch length dial to a higher number will give us zigzag stitches that are further apart. When we select the smaller size zigzag setting, the stitches will be narrower. The line is finished. We bring up the needle if needed. Lift the foot presser, remove the fabric, and cut the threads. Here are the results. Next, we are going to practice decorative stitches.